there has been this catastrophic moment. You've come through the flood. But the Lord allowed it. We know that. But we believe he allowed it so that we could go on to a greater thing, a better thing. The feeling in our nation, you know, there was difficulty, there was striving, there was a weight. And that, you know, was there before the flood. And the flood gave us a chance to focus on something together as a team and to work together and to deal with an emergency situation. But, you know, the roots of unforgiveness and brokenness and our inability as a society to have a civil conversation, it seems like, those things all start at home. Those all start with character and faith and what we believe about who we are and who God is. The fact is during an emergency, you know, we really do see the image of God imprinted on us. We see the value of every human that was lost. I remember the difference between Harvey as a storm that hadn't killed anybody yet and when it became a deadly storm.
Yeah.
And you think about one life lost was the difference there. And so the value of human life, the caring that we have for each other, it brought that out. And I think that needs to not be forgotten. All of the churches are working locally. Missio Dei, you know, wanted to have Resurrect Houston as a lasting effort that really lasted for potentially years. But I'm talking to the other churches. They have teams going out and they've got work that they're doing. And so the church is being the church everywhere. And so all of the churches need prayer. Please pray for all the pastors, the leadership staff. And I think they could all use some kind of resources. Volunteers are so valuable. To know that someone else is helping carry the load is a big deal. So we have a diocesan team that's also receiving volunteers, and we have houses all over the north side of Houston that have been opened up for people. So we've got a lot of capacity in the whole diocese to help do this work and make an impact. Houston's such a big city. We're just going to need every church and really every denomination, you know, everybody who calls in the name of Christ to be pushing forward in this work. A lot of the churches, you know, were in areas that didn't get tremendous amount. They had two or three families that got flooded, maybe a few more. But in the larger churches, you know, they have lists of names of people who are willing to take volunteers. And so there's all kinds of work to be done. Resurrect Houston is just the name we're giving to this effort. And so we keep it centered around what we're trying to accomplish, which is obviously the rebuilding, but even more. There's a lot of practical considerations. People have to have places to stay. They've got to have good work to do. So we're organizing around that. People can stay at Missio Dei at our building. We've got overflow in the neighborhood with our parishioners. And then additionally, we have workers, volunteer coordinator, a worksite coordinator, and an outreach coordinator that are working now. We're trying to ramp them up to full time so they can really provide good work, have vetted out families, and really connected the right work with the right families. We've got made some great partnerships already with people in the neighborhood who are helping us connect and know all of those answers. So we're just hoping people will want to send teams down. We're prepared to host teams and give them work to do and send resources to both help those teams, things like Sheetrock, finances for Sheetrock. If you want to send Sheetrock, you can. But then also finances to help our team support itself as it goes forward. I've been, you know, very blessed by both Matthew 25 and Anglican Relief and Development Fund. Right now, I know Anglican Relief and Development Fund is busy, and they're being administered by the diocese, helping people with immediate relief needs. But there will come a time where that will switch into these rebuilding efforts, and so we're very excited about. It's so good that we have this resource, but it's a great testament to what we can do as a church together, and that the things that we have to do together require more than just individual churches. We need the whole church, the whole body of Christ, working together.